Kritika Basu Ahuja, and today I am going to talk about corporate social responsibility. The term corporate social responsibility holds a lot of value in today's time because our country is still tagged as developing country. So, companies who are already set up, who are already established, doing good business for them, they now need to come out and contribute their bit to the society so that we sustain our development. So, let us understand what is corporate social responsibility. So, corporate social responsibility is basically a commitment of the business houses to behave ethically, which means you need to contribute your bit to the society for its development, social and economical both. While doing so, you are not only improving the quality of life of your employees because you have employed them, so you are paying them certain amount. At the same time, your responsibility towards the society and the community is also something which is your responsibility as an organization. So, when you start doing that, then you are fulfilling your corporate social responsibility. So, basically the fund provided under corporate social responsibility is for the social development for the society, dealing with the issues which are hampering the society, which are holding back the development of the society. So, the fund which is coming from the CSR is used for the development of the society. Let us now understand that when do you come into the criteria of CSR. So, the net worth of the company should be rupees 500 crores or more. So, if your company's net worth is 500 crores or more during the immediate preceding financial year, that is, then you are liable to do CSR. Or turnover of your company is rupees 1000 crore or more, then again you are liable to do CSR. Or net profit of your company is 5 crores or more, then again you are required to do CSR. So, if your company is falling under any of these categories, then you will have to do the CSR, that is corporate social responsibility activities. Now, it is very important for us to know that how do we actually go about it once we are falling into these categories. So, every qualifying company requires to spend at least 2% of its average net profit for the immediately preceding 3 years on CSR activities. So, whatever your company's profit has been for the preceding 3 years, of those profit you need to invest 2% on the CSR activity. Secondly, if your company's origin is not of our country, it is a foreign based company, however, it has its branches in the country, then again the company will have to do CSR activities. Now, those companies which have their branches in India, they would exclude the income from the overseas branches. However, the dividends distributed by company on which this section applies would be taken care of. If any company on which CSR provisions were applicable comes under these criteria consecutively for 3 years, then they are not required the provision of CSR. So, this is the applicability of CSR. Let's try and understand how do we implement these CSR activities. So, companies are allowed to implement CSR via these following methods. One, that you have to set up a trust, you can set up a trust or a society under section 8 of the 2013 Companies Act under its direct administrative control. Or corporate can outsource the CSR task to establish social enterprises institution. Like, you are a corporate house, but you do not have enough manpower to carry out the CSR activities. So, you can hire an NGO, give it fund to take care of your CSR activity. That's what this particular point means. These institutions are meant to engage not a profit activities, you know, it is not going to be a profit making activity that you give the fund to NGO and whatever, you know, the NGO's earning is, you take a share of it. It is going to be strictly a corporate social responsibility act. And the last one, companies, if you supposing alone you cannot do this activity, you feel that again the manpower and resources are not enough, then you can collaborate with some fellow companies and carry on with the CSR activities. You can have some arrangement to do some CSR activities. So this is how the CSR can be implemented. Then if you are a social entrepreneur, if your company is an NGO, then how can you take funds from CSR fund? One that you need to understand the clause 135 of Companies Act 2013. Two, you need to fill up the statutory requirement of an NGO. Then you need to try and identify the corporate donors in that area. Then also get the knowledge of activities for which you need CSR funds. So you need to understand the area wherein you want to work in or your company is already working in. Then you need to identify the corporate donors in your area. Moving on, you need to start building up a network, because it is, networking is very important. Nowadays, the saying is, if you are not networking, you are not working. So if you have network, then you will be able to channelize resources that are probably required to do that kind of an activity. So networking is very important. So you need to start building up a network. And then keep documented evidences ready. Whatever your plan is, the way you wish to go about those particular projects that you have as a social entrepreneur, the documented evidences should be ready of your plan, of your financial plan, of your organizational plan, your aim, your vision. Everything needs to be documented and it has to be ready at the time of asking for fund. Then look for resources required. So it is not only networking, but you need to also identify which organization has the kind of resources that you require. So some organization may give you the funding, some organization may give you the manpower, some organization may provide you the vehicle facility, some organization may help you market your idea or maybe advertise your idea. So you need to identify the resources that you need for that particular project. Then it is very important to ask for the feedback from your donors, because on the basis of your feedback, you can continue to do the right work and also improvise the wherever you are going wrong. So feedback plays a very important role for you to get into the right direction and set expectations right as to what are you looking for, meaning when you get this fund, what are you going to deliver and what kind of fund do you need for that. So that is setting your expectation right. And when you are a social entrepreneur, going by this, you will be able to get the funds easily and your work would be in the right direction. Moving on. There are various activities which can be done under CSR. Now you need to identify which is your interest area or maybe in which area your company would be comfortable working in. So the very first area is healthcare, wherein eradicating hunger, poverty, malnutrition, basically spreading awareness or maybe providing food material or distributing food grains and all that to the poor people. So this could be one activity and this will also contribute to the Swachh Bharat Kosh, because herein we are also talking about sanitation, cleanliness. So this is basically working for the rural population of our country. Then the second point is promoting education. Now this area is equally important, because most of our population in the rural area is not educated. So when we are providing education, with that we are also generating opportunities for employment, because when they have studied, they will get employment easily, and thereby you can also bring in the vocational trainings for them so that they can start earning their living on their own. So this is another area where you can look for skill development trainings or maybe education trainings. So then you can bring about development in those areas. Then your fund would go into providing education and vocational training. The third area is promoting gender equality, empowering women, setting up homes and hostels for the women and orphans. So this is the third area wherein you can give funds to promoting gender equality, empowering women by, you know, spreading awareness or giving them some sort of opportunities of employment, or maybe setting up homes for those who do not have homes, women and orphans. Now the fourth area is the environment. Now we hear a lot about protection of environment, the air pollution, the water pollution, the damage caused by plastics, the global warming. So one can actually start giving fund for the environmental projects wherein lot of work is going on to save the environment. So one could be the environmental area wherein one can give funds. Moving on, the fifth area is protection of national heritage. Our country is rich of national heritage wherein we have lots of monuments, art, architecture, cultural heritage, which is day by day either disappearing or they are getting ruined. One can actually contribute to restore our heritage and culture and contribute the fund to those organizations who are working in this field. Now the sixth one is measure for the benefits of armed forces. We know each year a lot of casualties happen in the armed forces. Those people also need funds, their wives, their families, their children, they require a lot of funds to live their life. So one can always contribute to the armed forces. Seventh, training to promote rural sports, nationally recognized sports, Paralympic sports and Olympic sports. So there are areas where there is a lot of potential in people for sports. However, they do not have enough opportunities for trainings, the gears that they need to play those sports. So organizations can actually give funds to development of sports activities as well. Now the eighth one is contributions to the Prime Minister's National Relief Fund or any other fund set up by the central government. So we get to hear each year a lot of natural calamities happening in our country, and for that we all need to come out and do our bit. So these funds have been set up for people like us, the contribution by the organizations to come out and give funds to these relief funds so that can be utilized to help out those victims. Then ninth one, contribution or fund provided to technology incubators located within the academic institution. So lot of academic institutions are now into doing a lot of innovation, so they have incubator center, but that also needs fund to run. So that can be another area where you can actually channelize your fund. Moving on, the 10th one is rural development project. Since we know that we are a developing country and a lot of area is a rural area which is still, you know, neglected. So lot of projects are being undertaken for the rural development. So companies can provide fund to rural development projects as well. Then slum area development. Each city has a big slum area wherein people are living in a very unhygienic condition. The opportunity for education is less, the employment is less. So companies can also give funds to the slum development projects. And then other activities. There are so many other activities happening in our country. Like I know Dr. Reddy's is doing CSR to develop the paramedical staff. Similarly, lot of other companies, wherever they feel there is a need to do the CSR funding. They just go on and give their funds in that direction. So you need to be an alert citizen. You need to be an alert businessman. You need to be an alert entrepreneur so that you understand that your nation, your country needs you and needs you to do your bit for the social development of our country. So I hope it was a beneficial session for you. Thank you so much.